clear is this government does not want to have the public know what's in this bill. We had to fight hard to get up to 48 witnesses. The government first said we'll just have 18, 10 from us, and 8 from the opposition. So we fought hard, did a filibuster, so that we could have at least 48 Canadians before the House. But I've never been more ashamed of the House of Commons than I was this week when those witnesses began to appear. The Conservatives actually asked Greenpeace, "Are you or are you not a threat to national security?" And then they said, "Sorry, no time for you to answer that." The first Muslim witness who appeared was accused of being lukewarm in his opposition to terrorism. And I have never seen a more dignified response by someone under attack from elected representatives. When Chief Perry Bellegarde appeared before the committee, he was lectured for 5.5 minutes by the Conservatives on Aboriginal rights. And when we challenged that disrespect, the Conservatives said, "We were glad he was here so we could explain to him." What is the purpose of these hearings? It's for the government to listen to Canadians. So this week we had our first 12 witnesses, including 3 government witnesses. And what happened? 12 out of 12 said this bill is a bad bill, including the government's own witnesses. Problematic in this bill. The first is the provision that would allow the government departments to share all information with each other on each and every one of us, which has nothing to do with terror. The Privacy Commissioner has said this will allow a personal profile on every Canadian to be constructed by the government. When we asked to have the Privacy Commissioner before the committee, what do you think happened? The Conservatives blocked his appearance. They don't want you to know what's in this bill. When legal experts appeared before the committee on the new disruptive powers of CSIS, they were asked, "Does this allow CSIS to do kidnapping, secret detentions, and rendition, which means sending people to other countries?" And the answer is, this bill allows that.
Yes.
And when it comes to detentions, you will now be subject to detention in Canada if you are suspected that you might do something against the security of Canada.
That's
this bill
here.
Must go. We have to raise our voices all across the country. We have to make the Conservatives understand that this is a threat to their re-election, and then we have to drive them out of office. I think the true patriots in this country are standing before me today, defending fundamental freedoms, defending our way of life, and defending Canadian values. And I look forward to all of you working with me as we go forward and with all of our other allies at the community level to make sure we don't lose what's great about this nation. Thank you.